In this video, we're going to compare the Vetroo V5 versus the Hyper 212 RGB using this test bench right here. Before we begin, let's look at some qualitative metrics. Both CPU cooler images show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, both coolers will not have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Both coolers each use a single 120mm fan, and it is possible to add an additional fan on both coolers. In regards to installation, the Vetroo is easier to install, while the hypercooler installation is very involved, requires many steps, and can prove to be challenging for beginners. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds, and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over 1 million data points in an open case. This means that the performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows the temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the Vetroo cooler in red to the Hyper cooler in blue, both coolers perform similarly under 70% fan speed. However, given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we see that both coolers perform similarly, while the Vetroo V5 produces more noise after approximately 50% fan speed. Next, we will look at the CPU overclock to 125 watts. This shows that neither fan handles overclock temperatures well and would experience throttling. Next, we will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the coolers by normalized noise levels, we see that the Vetroo performs slightly better at higher noise levels. However, as we increase the watts to 105, we can see that the Hyper begins to slightly outperform. This trend continues as we move to 125 watts. Overall, both coolers perform similarly regarding cooling performance. However, the Hyper 212 runs much quieter at higher speeds, making the Hyper 212 the winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.